Seemed like a pretty clear-cut choice in the fourth between Walker and Vesia for Rosario, maybe even for the pinch hitter. Take us through that decision.
I just felt right there the way Walker was throwing. I expect him to keep going, and the stuff wasn't compromised. There's a walk to Darnell, then the broken bat double, and I just felt that he had enough stuff to get through that and to keep going. He got ahead 0-2, and we just couldn't put him away.
Does his big game reputation in that situation sort of factor too?
I just felt in that moment he was the best option. I think that you're looking at the fourth inning and where Walker, how he's throwing the baseball, I felt he was the best option. And, you know, with what he did this year, he was amazing. And right there, again, we got ahead and we just couldn't put him away. And you got to give credit to Rosario, who put a great swing on a 1-2 cutter in or whatever it was.
Okay. Down in front here, Juan.
Hey, Dave, what was kind of your message to the guys after
the game? The message was, I think that obviously we didn't. First off, let me just congratulate the Braves, the entire organization, Brian, his staff, Alex, his staff, and what they did, the players, coaches, those guys did a fantastic job, and they beat us in a series. So wish them well. I think for my message to our guys, it was basically, it was a tremendous season. It was a heck of a year. Going through a lot of different things that we went through that no one talked about, no one needed to talk about, and didn't let it affect our performance. And that's something I was proud of. To win 106 games, to go through a wild card game, to then be pushed in a 5-game series against a division rival, to come out of that, and to be 2 wins away from going to the World Series. I think for me, I wanted those guys to be proud of that because the entire organization, not just the guys in the room, you know, there's people that all across our organization that worked really hard for this season. And to say that it was a lost season or a wasted season or anything, you've never been in a major league clubhouse and understands the sacrifices, understand the sacrifice that people make. So it's still not lost on any of us that we didn't accomplish our goal. But for me, I'm giving credit to the Braves because they outplayed us, plain and simple.
Down on the right, Fabian.
Hey, Dave, you mentioned it was the cutter that Rosario got to. What did you think of that sequence? It seemed like they were going hard. Like we had some.
You know, obviously that's a pitch that, you know, Walker feels good with, but certainly you can tell that Rosario was sped up. And, you know, I don't want to second guess a sequence, but certainly, you know, we could have done different things, but we didn't. But certainly he was on the hard stuff, yeah.
And I know we've asked you about the offense, but did you feel like you guys were building something there in the seventh before, obviously, Albert and that three spot came up?
I did. I thought they were good at bats, and then Pollock keeping the ball fair. I thought that that was a chance for us to get to Jackson, which we did, and Brian went to Matzik, and we just didn't have an answer for him. But that was a big opportunity that we just couldn't, you know, even push one across. But, again, Matzik made pitches when he needed to.
Next question, Mike, on the right.
I don't know how much you've seen Rosario over the years, but just how much of a beast was he in this series?
I'm sure he's holding the MVP trophy of the CS. We just couldn't figure him out. He beat us the other way. He beat us to the poolside. He got hits off lefties, off righties. We tried to spin him. We went hard. We just didn't have an answer for him. And when you've got that big guy looming behind him, it's just kind of tough to pitch around him, who was clearly hot. But yeah, we just didn't have an answer for him.
On the left, Bill.
Dave, you mentioned all the team went through to get this far. You also lost a lot of important people along the way. Did you just feel like you ran out of gas tonight?
I hate conceding that. I just felt that we had the players that were active that could still win this series. We were ready to play through October. We just didn't get it done. But when you take hits like we took, there's still, you know, our best, I don't know. It's just, It's tough because I don't want to take anything away from the Braves. They beat us in a series. We put our best foot forward. We fought. And they beat us in a series.
Right there in the middle.
Hey, Dave. What did you think of Ian Anderson and his changeup? Did it kind of get you guys off balance early in the game, considering the strikeouts that he had? And what kind of adjustment do you think you guys could have made for, as a difference?
I thought the one thing, I wouldn't say it caught us off guard. I think a little bit the adjustment that they did make, and I'm seeing it from the side. I thought that they went in with the fastball more than he typically does, where usually it's the fastball or the changeup down below in to the right-handed, where he mixed it up with that lane by throwing a fastball to keep us honest a little bit. So, like I said, we had our chance, but you got to give credit. Ian pitched a nice ball game.
Okay, down in front here, Juan.
Dave, this core has accomplished basically everything together. I know this is kind of out of your control, but there's a lot of roster decisions this winter. Can you even process the fact that this might be the last time this group is together?
That's a fair question. A lot's going to be happening this winter. I think part of the great thing about players and service time is you get to a chance to choose where you want to play and earn what you want to earn. So we have some guys that are free agents, and we all know who they are. So potentially to not see those guys back, it's sort of a changing of the guard. If they're not back, whoever's not back, I'm certainly going to miss them personally, and our team's going to miss them. The 6 years that I've been here, it's been a core group of guys that potentially could be turned over this winter. I'm not looking forward to it. They're great players and great men, and I wish we could have won another one with this group.
Right in the front here, Mike.
Dave, to piggyback off that a little bit, a lot of those guys are future Hall of Famers. Did you have any private talks with them at all after this game in case, like you said, you might not see him again? And then now that it's done, Cody's complete turnaround from the regular season to the postseason, I thought that was a great at-bat going to beat the shift there to get that first run. And what can you say about what he did in the two different seasons?
Cody, it was great. And we've talked about it for, you know, recently. And it's something that I think he's going to look back and be very proud of himself and how he overcame such crazy adversity. And he's going to be better for it. As far as the message, I gave the opportunity to some players to talk to the guys, and there's no script. You don't plan for this talk, you know, losing an elimination game. So Clayton, Justin, Albert, Max said a few things, but I think the thing that landed with me is, you know, Albert talking about this group of guys, that how special it was.
AJ, you're on the left.
Dave, dating to that decision to use Max when you did in the NLDS, it seemed like your pitching staff was kind of up against it this whole series in terms of short rest and some guys battling through arm stuff. How do you look at that in retrospect now, and was there anything to do differently there, or is it just kind of the way the series unfolded?
Well, in retrospect, you know, and if you could guarantee that we could win game five with someone else, I would have used someone else different. I just think in the moment, talking to coaches, staff, and in particular Max, and having done that, and a veteran player who I trust, there's a point that you just got to trust the player, and I trusted Max. So it just didn't work out. But yeah, we were kind of behind it and fighting an uphill battle, you know, this entire series. But I really believe, regardless, we got beat. I mean, the Braves played a heck of a series. I think offensively, they game planned against us really well. Defensively or pitching wise, I think that they prepared for our hitters really well.
Anything else for Doc? Doc, as always, thank you.
All right, thanks, guys.
Thank you.